Hey everybody, Jesus loves you, my name is Cody, and you're watching the Monday episode of the Christian News Show thing that I do. And there's no black screen behind me. Truth! So a couple things before I get into the news stories. You're probably going to notice these sooner or later. I don't know if you can see them. It's HD though, so probably. Pretty much what happened was, I went to this glitter factory, got a bunch of glitter dumped on me, and I went outside, and these werewolves kept calling me Edward and attacking me, and they all scratched me up, and that's what happened. That or my girlfriend's parents' cat attacked me. That could be it too. Whichever story you prefer. But I am in South Dakota. I might make a vlog thing showing you around my house a little bit. This is my girlfriend's house, her old room, office thing. So we'll be here for a couple videos, so it's not the normal setup that we usually have. But I did feel bad because I didn't have a video last Thursday, and I didn't really tell you guys about it because I forgot. I did leave it in the video, and there's a little writing, it was really fast. But I'm back. I'm sorry that I didn't have one Thursday. I tried. I had a lot of schoolwork to do. So now you're all caught up on my news, and then we go to, like, real news that matters. Like news that Peyton Manning is a Bronco and Tim Tebow is a Jet. And I love that last year Tim Tebow made Bronco news Christian news for me. The only reason I like Tim Tebow is because he brought the Broncos to the playoffs. He knew how to play. So there was that. And I mean, there is a Christian thing, and I'm really glad that he does that. But I mean, Peyton Manning's Christian. He's just not as outspoken about it as Tim Tebow is. I'm a little worried about Peyton Manning's injuries that he's had over the past few years. But the doctors say he's good, and I'm going to trust the Broncos' millions of dollars of investment that they've put into the guy. Peyton Manning is one of the best quarterbacks in the NFL, so as a Broncos fan, I am excited. But that's not really Christian-type news, so we can go on to our next story. News such as the American Bible Challenge, hosted by Jeff Foxworthy. But yeah, this is a real game show that's going to be on GSN, which is the Game Show Network. And it's going to be a question-answer game about the Bible, to see how much people really know. And the one thing that really does bug me about the game show is that they are only choosing worthy faith-based organizations, not unworthy faith-based organizations. I just don't see what makes something worthy. Are you a worthy Christian or are you an unworthy Christian? And then there's just the simple fact that it's a Christian game show, which is pretty weird in itself. I remember just recently talking about how funny it'd be to have a Christian reality show. And I mean, a game show really isn't that far off. It's also going to be hosted by Jeff Foxworthy, which is interesting. He's also been seen in an Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader hosting that, and just being hilarious anywhere he goes. I'm sure if you've seen him, you've seen him being funny. He's hilarious. I might watch an episode of it. I'm not much of a game show type person, but it should be interesting how this plays out. I'm glad that Christianity is having game shows now, I guess. I mean, Christianity itself isn't something to make light of, but I'm glad that we're getting Christianity pushed into every nook and cranny of anything that people spend their time doing. So, there's that, and we go to our next story. Our third story is about Trayvon Martin. I'm sure you guys have all heard about his murder already. And if you guys haven't heard the story already, George Zimmerman was a guy that appointed himself as the head of the neighborhood watch. And Trayvon was a teenager, simply going to a candy store, and Zimmerman followed him. Zimmerman called the police, said that he was following the teenager to make sure he wasn't in any trouble, and then ended up murdering him, saying that he was using self-defense. Now, Trayvon Martin was shot, but all that he had was a bag of Skittles and a can of tea that he got from the convenience store. The neighborhood saying that Zimmerman is somewhat of a racist, and it becomes apparently obvious that this was a hate crime. And with all that being said, the biggest part of this is that Zimmerman wasn't arrested. They said there's not enough evidence to call it a hate crime, so they didn't arrest him for it, and they just said that it was self-defense, like he said. And that's just trying to catch you up, but the new news is everybody that's uprising on this, which is awesome. People are protesting in the streets, things like that, and churches everywhere, people are wearing hoodies to church. The whole idea is to bring awareness, because Trayvon Martin was just a black teenager in a hoodie, and he wasn't doing anything wrong, but because of that stereotype, that's the reason he got murdered. So it's awesome that all of these churches are bringing awareness to this. And obviously, it's not just churches, it's everywhere, but these are pastors wearing hoodies, it's the people in the congregation wearing hoodies, everybody was wearing hoodies. I wasn't aware until after church, or I would have wore a hoodie. But like I said, I didn't hear about it until later. I'm really glad that people are doing stuff like this. This stuff just needs to be brought to awareness. It's stupid that we still have these kind of hate crimes today in the United States. So, props to church, and props to anybody that's spreading the word. And the last story is about a man whose name I can't pronounce. Sheikh Abdul Aziz bin Abdullah. That. There would have been no way of me ever getting that right. He's a great mufti. Sorry, Islam people, I'm not pronouncing any of your words right. Either way, he's a big guy for Islam, kind of like a pope type thing for Islam. And he has declared that not only should churches be destroyed, but they need to be destroyed. He's saying that Saudi Arabia can't have two different religions, and that all churches need to be demolished. Christian churches. And now I'm reading the article, link in the description below, and they brought up a really good point. If the Pope said that all the churches need to be destroyed, then you'd have, like, condolences from the president, and, like, everybody would riot, and things would happen. But in America, we're trying to be pro-Islam, so if an Islamist says it, we just keep quiet. And I do get that there's obvious reasons for the countries to try to stay away from that and say, you know, Islam is not bad people. Because they're not. I obviously don't agree with a lot of their beliefs, but I also don't know enough about Islam to understand what's totally going on. when you look at this in another view, it's not a religion's decision, but a human's decision to say that you can't have freedom of religion in your country, then that's bad. So I've got to figure that we as Americans didn't say anything when this happened. Usually the president comes up, he's like, I give my condolences to these people or whatever, but there was nothing. I haven't heard anything except from this news story. And again, I'm sure they have their reasons, but to take away someone's freedom of religion, to me, isn't right, because that's taking away a freedom. And I also think it's stupid that America didn't speak up simply because we don't want people to think that Muslims are bad people. I'm kind of interested in your guys' opinions on that stuff. I don't really have a question for that, but I do have a question of the day that's separate, and that question of the day comes from a comment in my last video. Someone's kind of said that I've taken Jesus out of these videos. And he also talked about that I don't talk about the verse of the day as much. I tried cutting down time, and I thought that was a good place to do it, because I'm hoping that the verse of the day corresponds enough with the news stories that it kind of fits together and I don't have to explain. But I am really curious about what you guys think about all that. And along with that, what else would you guys want me to change dealing with this show? So that's kind of the question today. What do you guys think I should change about the news show? As always, I love to see what you guys say, so leave a comment in the comment section below with your answer. If you're a subscriber and you answer the comment section below, you're then eligible to win a $10 gift card to C2A.com or Amazon.com, depending on what you choose. So go do that and go to the verse of the day. And the verse of the day is 1 John 3:13. Do not be surprised, my brothers, if the world hates you. To me, it's kind of crazy that Christianity is illegal in so many different countries. Because if you have it where it's openly okay to talk about Jesus, people become Christian. And for some reason, countries seem to be scared of that fact. Even if they're so strong in their faith, they just know that Jesus will overpower it no matter what. So, that's all I found interesting in the news today. In closing, haters keep hating, Christians keep praying. To everybody, like and subscribe. I will see you later, and God bless.
Hold on, I'm gonna drink some Coke in my Enjoy Coca-Cola shirt. Enjoy Jesus. Enjoy cola.